Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's look at using the keyboard as a trackpad in iOS 9. So a new feature of iOS 9 is the ability to use the keyboard as a trackpad for selecting text. So I've just put some sample text here in a note, and you can do this in any app where you're entering text in. So you can do it in Mail and Pages, etc. And I can tap in the note and select some text. It's very easy to do. I can even do the thing where I tap and hold and I get a little magnifying glass there and I can select exactly where I want. Now this could be a little hard. You can see I just had a little difficulty there selecting that first character just before it. And then if I were to hit select, it would select the whole word, and I can drag and try my best to select what I want. Now it's a little easier using the keyboard. Here's how you do it. I've got the normal keyboard there, and you can see I've got the cursor somewhere in the text. It's not where I want it to be. I'm going to tap on the keyboard with two fingers and immediately, without hesitation, move those two fingers in unison, and it will act as a way to move that cursor. Notice that the letters on the keyboard will go blank to indicate this is working. So you can see now I'm controlling this cursor, and the letters on the keyboard are now blank, and I can put it where I want and release. Now what about selection? Well, you could do the thing where you have the cursor right here and you tap on it and you hit select. And now notice that if I were to do the two fingers and move it, it takes the second part of that, the right part of that, and it allows me to move that very easily. So you can position the cursor where you want at the beginning and use the trackpad feature to select like that. Or another thing you could do is you have the cursor somewhere and you tap with two fingers, but instead of moving those fingers immediately, you hesitate just a little bit and it will automatically go into selection mode. So watch where the cursor is. I'm going to tap with two fingers and you can see how it changed to have two dots. Looks like a vertical barbell there. And now I can drag the end of that selection anywhere I want, or I can actually drag before it to be the beginning of that selection. So it's slightly a different way to use it, and it's a little confusing at first because when you're first learning to use this feature, your thought is that I'm going to tap with two fingers and did I do it? Yeah, I did it. Oh, well now I'm in selection mode. So you have to get used to, if you want to select something, position the cursor, tap and move immediately before you can go into selection mode. Now there's more subtleties to it as well. I find if you tap with two fingers just really quickly, just a quick tap and lift up on the keyboard, it selects the word where the cursor is located. And if you do it again, just a quick tap with two fingers, deselects it. If I do a double tap quickly with two fingers, selects the line. Quick tap with two fingers, deselects. Now triple tap, and I get the whole paragraph. I can tap away. Some people are going to love this new feature and others are going to hate it because it's so easy to get the gestures just a little bit wrong and actually type some characters. So for instance, if I just touch just slightly off with my two fingers, you can see I typed instead of actually using the gesture. And if I get it just right, you can see I do the selection. And it's very easy to select something and then go to move around. So say I'm going to want to move this paragraph. I can tap with two fingers and now I can continue to edit, or I just tap a little bit off and I've just replaced the entire paragraph with just two characters, and then I'm going to have to use undo to get it back. So it's something you want to practice. You want to use in Pages or Notes or something and practice, because if you can get this down, it certainly can make handling text in iOS 9 a lot easier.